is Asha here. Today I will be discussing on the Big M method. Big M method is used to solve the linear programming problems. In that, we will be discussing on the minimization problem. So let's look into the problem. We have to solve the given problem using Big M method. So the problem is minimization Z is equal to 2x1 plus x2 subjected to three different constraints and a non-negativity constraint. So here the problem is of minimization. So first step, check whether the problem is maximization or minimization type. So here the problem is of minimization. So convert the minimization problem to maximization problem by multiplying by minus 1. So your problem will become maximum Z dash will be equal to minus 2x1 minus x2. Next step is to convert to the standard form. So the problem is given in the canonical form. So you need to convert to a standard form. Let's look into the problem. So the first equation or the inequalities or the constraint is given as x1 plus 2x2 lesser than or equal to 4. If you are having inequality lesser than or equal to, add a slack variable to it and make it equal to 4. Okay. So the next is having inequality greater than or equal to. Then subtract surplus variable and add an artificial variable to it. If you already having an equal to sign or the equation, then add just the artificial variables. So it has been converted to a standard form like this. For the first equation, you have the inequality lesser than or equal to. You have added S1 as the slack variable. Second equation, you have inequality greater than or equal to. So subtract the surplus variable S2 and add an artificial variable A1. Third is having equal to sign. So just add the artificial variable A2. So rewrite your objective function in terms of these slack, surplus, and artificial variables. So your equation is maximize Z dash equal to minus 2x1 minus x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 minus m into a1 minus m into a2. For slack and surplus variable, the coefficient in the objective function will be 0. And for the artificial variable, it is always minus m. It is always minus m. Okay. So rewrite the table now. First will be the basic variable. So basic variable will be S1, A1 and A2. You should never consider the surplus variable as your basic variable in the first iteration because it is associated with negative sign and it does not contribute to a unit matrix. So your basic variables will be S1, A1 and A2. See, the coefficient of S1, S2, A1 and A2 in the objective functions are 0, minus m and minus m. So write down in the table, first column, the basic variables are S1, A1 and A2 and the coefficient of those basic variables are 0, minus m and minus m. Again, the coefficient of variables are in the objective function are x1, x2, s1, s2, a1, a2. So write the respective coefficient from the objective function. So it is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 0, minus m and minus m. So to fill this table, for the first equation is x1 plus 2x2 plus s1 is equal to 4. So wherever the x1, the coefficient is 1, x2 coefficient is 2, s1 is 1, you don't have s2, a1 and a2. So the coefficient of s2, a1, a2 in the first equations are 0. So you have 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 0 and the constant is 4, that is RHS. Second equation, you have 4, 3, 0, minus 1, 1 and 0, constant is 6. So write down in the same order, whatever the coefficient present, there represent those numbers. Third equation, 3, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 and the constant is 3. 3, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 3. So here, first get the z equation. How you? Summation of CBO into XI. So CBO will be the constant. Multiply by first column or second column, third column, fourth column. It goes on like this. So summation of all the three. CBO into XI minus CO. Coefficient in that respective column. So it will be 0 into 1 is 0. Minus m into 4 minus 4m minus 3m. So it will become minus 7m. Summation of these two is minus 7m. Minus of minus 2 is plus 2. So minus 7m plus 2 is the z equation value for this column. Second one is 0 minus 3m minus m. So minus m into 1 minus m into 3. So minus 4m minus of minus 1 is plus 1. So it is minus 4m plus 1. Next will be 0 into 1 is 0, 0, 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. 0 minus m into minus 1 is plus m. So this will be plus m. So 0 minus m minus of minus m is 0. Minus m minus of minus m is 0. So in this z equation, most negative value, assume m as 100. So it is minus 700 plus 2. So it is minus 698, you can assume. So here it is minus 400 plus 1 is minus 399. Most negative value, highest negative value is minus 7m plus 2. So this will become the key column. Get the ratios, constant divided by that key column element, 1, it is 4, 6 by 4 is 1.5, 3 divided by 3 is 1. Among these ratio, least positive ratio has to be selected, so it is 1, so this will become the key row. So intersection of key column with key row is called the key element. So here 3 is called the key element. So in the next table, x1 is entering the table and a2, that row, will be departing the table. So next table, the variables are s1, a1 and x1. So here a2 will be leaving and you need not have to consider the value for that a2 column. So here this 3 has to become 1 and 4 and 1 has to become 0. Okay. So in order to carry out that, you will be having r4, r5, r6. R6 will be equal to r3 by 3. So if you divide this by 3, then this value, key element value, will become 1. So it is 1, 1 by 3, 0, 0, 0, 1 by 3 and 3 by 3 is 1 in the next table. 1, 1 by 3, 0, 0, you need not have to calculate 1. So next, this 4 has to become 0. So what is the operation you are carrying out for the fifth row? It is R2, that is R2 minus 4 by 3 into R3. So 4 by 3 of 3 is 4. So 4 minus 4 will become 0. Again, next, 3 minus 4 by 3 is 5 by 3. Again, 0 minus 0 will be 0. Minus 1 of plus 0 into 4 by 3 is minus 1. 1 minus 0 into 4 by 3 is 1. Again, 0 minus 4 by 3. So A2 has departed. You need not have to calculate. 6 minus 4 by 3 of 3 is 4. So 6 minus 4 will become 2. Similarly, for the R4, okay, for the fourth row, R1 minus R3 by 3. R1 minus R3 by 3. So 1 minus 3 by 3 is 1. So 1 minus 1 will become 0. 2 minus 1 by 3. So it is 5 by 3. Again, 1 minus 0 will be 1. 0 minus 0 is 0. 0. A2 you need not have to calculate. 4 minus 1 by 3 into 3. That is 4 minus 1 will be 3. Again, you calculate the Z equation. This is 0. Again, 0 into 5 by 3 is 0. 1 into 0 into 0 minus M into 0 minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Second column, it is 0 into 5 by 3 is 0, minus 5m by 3, minus 2 by 3, plus 1. So it will be minus 5m plus 1 by 3. So since m is having a higher value, minus 500 plus 1 is minus 499 by 3, it is having a negative value. So again, it is 0, 0, 0, so it is 0, minus plus m, minus 0 is m. Then again, it is 0, 1, minus m, plus m is 0. You need not have to calculate this. So most negative value is the x2 row, x2 column. So this becomes the key column. So get the ratio, 3 divided by 5 by 3 is 9 by 3, 2 divided by 5 by 3 is 6 by 5, 1 divided by 1 by 3 is 3. Least positive value is 6 by 5, so this will be the key row. So 5 by 3 will be the key element. So x2 will be entering the table and a1 will be departing the table. So next table, basic variables will be s1, x2 and x1, and this 5 by 3 has to become 1 and the other elements has to become 0. So if you want the 8th row to be unit element, so it will be R5 into, if you multiply by 3 by 5, R5 into 3 by 5, then this element will become 1. Similarly, for the R4, for the R7, it is R4 minus R5 will give the value 0. Similarly, for R9, it is R6 minus R5 by 5. So R5 by 5. So this value becomes 0. So calculate like that for the entire row. Apply these row operations and get the value. Now, coming to the Z equation. It is 0 into 0, 0, minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Again, it is minus 1 plus of, minus of minus 1 is plus 1, it is 0. Here all the values are 0. Again here, plus 3 by 5, minus 2 by 5 is 1 by 5. So you need not have to calculate for A1, A2. And the RHS are 1, 6 by 5 and 3 by 5 respectively. Since in the Z equation, all the values are positive, so no more iteration. This is the optimal solution. So you see the table, RHS table, X2 value is 6 by 5, x1 value is 3 by 5. Substitute in the main objective function and the value is 12 by 5. Thank you.